grain business, where Marubeni boasts the largest transaction volume among general trading companies, the division is further expanding a global network of procurement and sales. For example, forming a comprehensive alliance with the Sinograin Group, China's largest grain reserves corporation. In the field of food distribution, Marubeni has a strong presence in sales and has established a distribution network utilizing its global procurement capability. The division will develop business aggressively to secure the internal demand of growing markets such as China and ASEAN. The Lifestyle Division now handles a wide variety of lifestyle products for consumers, such as clothing and footwear. The division has formed an expansive value chain from project proposals that accurately track consumer trends to manufacturing, importation, sales, and brand development. Recently, the division has strengthened its OEM system centered on China to build a framework providing high-quality products quickly, stably, and at low cost. This has resulted in strong sales of fashion items and footwear for major mass retailers. The Forest Products Division is active in a wide range of business and trade, forming a strong value chain from raw material to products in the field of forest industry, an industry that has received renewed attention in recent years. The division's forestation woodchip business is one of the largest for Japanese companies, and going forward, the division will continue to secure competitive forestation resources. In addition, the pulp production and sales business has been improving its operational efficiency and manufacturing cost structure since the global economic downturn of 2008. In pursuit of continued increase in profit, the division has strengthened its operational base for industrial paper manufacturing and sales in China and ASEAN. The Chemicals Division provides to various industrial fields the chemicals that serve as precursors to petrochemicals, inorganic and agricultural chemicals, electronic material, specialty chemicals, synthetic resins, and vinyl alkalis. Also, the division has investments in numerous businesses in Asia, America, Europe, and Australia. Recently, trading has been very active in the growing fields of LEDs, secondary batteries, and solar batteries. The division is also involved in environmentally friendly plant factory systems. Going forward, the division will continue to develop a portfolio of promising businesses. The main businesses of the Energy Division 1 are the trading and marketing of LNG, petroleum, and natural gas. The LNG department is working on projects and trading with Qatar, Equatorial Guinea, and Peru. The petroleum and natural gas trading department trades globally, utilizing a network of overseas locations. The marketing department uses its inventiveness to compete in the markets for domestic petroleum products and LPG. For the Lafan refinery project in Qatar, the division is focusing on maintaining a stable operation and expanding its trade advantages. The main businesses of the Energy Division 2 are upstream resource development and nuclear fuel. The Resource Development Department is promoting the development and production of petroleum, natural gas, and uranium in countries such as the US, UK, India, Qatar, Russia, and Kazakhstan. The Nuclear Fuel Department focuses on global procurement and sale of uranium, solution services related to each step of the nuclear fuel cycle, and sales of nuclear power equipment and material. The Metals and Mineral Resources Division is developing a wide variety of businesses, from trading and upstream businesses, such as metal mine development and refining, to downstream businesses, such as product sales and recycling, as well as new fields, such as next generation energy. A financing contract totaling 1.7 billion US dollars was concluded with the Esperanza and El Tesoro copper mine projects in Chile. The operations and sales at Lake Vermont Coal Mine in Australia are doing very well. From April 2010, the Steel Product Department was integrated into the division to further expand its business operations. The Transportation Machinery Division trades in various fields such as aerospace, defense, automotive, construction machinery, agro-machinery, and ships. The Aerospace Department delivers jet aircraft manufactured by the Brazilian company Embraer to JAL Group and Fuji Dream Airlines. The Ship Department is engaged in trading in chartered ships and freight forwarding, as well as global shipping businesses such as fleet holding. The Automotive, Construction Machinery, and Agro-Machinery departments are focusing on fields less dependent on economic conditions, such as after-sales services. In the future, the division will invest in new fields such as leasing and sales financing with an aim to strengthen its functions and expand its business foundation. The Power Projects and Infrastructure Division works globally, focusing on overseas IPP business and desalination projects. As of June 2010, the Overseas IPP Department held the largest equity power generating capacity among the trading companies at 7,599 megawatts. Meanwhile, the Desalination Department plans to join the world's top 10 for population supplied with water within a few years. Additionally, the Electricity and Water Project Construction Contracting Department has a solid reputation around the world, particularly in Asia and the Middle East. The division will continue to establish new business models while balancing revenue growth with social contribution through infrastructure development. The Plant and Industrial Machinery Division consists of four segments. The plant segment, which works with petroleum, natural gas, chemicals, iron making, cement, and pulp and paper. The Global Environment Project segment, which works with clean development mechanisms. The Industrial Machinery and Production Machinery segment, and the Transport Project Management segment. Each segment utilizes its experience and know-how to propose the best solution for clients' projects. The division is also focusing on creating new businesses through cooperation with domestic and international strategic partners. The Real Estate Development Division covers a wide range of real estate and affiliated businesses. The domestic condominium business handles everything from product planning to sales and post-sales management service under the brand name Grand Suite. In the income-producing property business, the division develops and operates office buildings and commercial facilities as a developer. The Overseas Real Estate Development Department was the first Japanese real estate developer in China and has a record of success developing 4,000 houses, mainly in Shanghai. The Finance, Logistics, and IT Business Division operates in a relatively new field for a trading company and provides various business services. The Finance and Insurance Business Department handles fund management, leasing, and insurance brokerage utilizing the strengths of a trading company. The Logistics Business Department provides optimum logistics solutions for clients, while the IT Business Department provides comprehensive IT solutions such as data communication network services for enterprises. Recently, looking to the future, the division has participated in the asset management business, business development in the fields of cloud computing and RFID, and the further strengthening of its strategies in the Chinese and ASEAN markets. In addition to the activities of the 12 sales divisions, Matabeni also has been making contributions to wider society from an early stage, focusing on such areas as social welfare and global environment. The core of the company's social welfare activities is the Matabeni Fund, established in 1974. Since its establishment, the fund has granted funds in excess of 100 million Japanese yen in total each year to social welfare facilities and organizations throughout Japan. Such funds have also been established in Southeast Asian countries, such as the Philippines, providing locally based support through scholarships and donations. Measures for the global environment include implementation of environmentally friendly business operations, proactive support for various environmental conservation activities, and participation in renewable energy operations from an early stage. These activities have been successful economically as well as socially and environmentally, and Matabeni has been recognized by external institutions as a company with excellent sustainability.
Hello, I am Teruo Asada, President and CEO of Matabeni Corporation. As you can see, Matabeni has a history of more than 150 years, and our business models and operations as a general trading company are extremely diverse. At the present time, we are conducting business throughout the world, together with many partners and customers, by making full use of our network of 118 overseas branches and offices in 71 countries. There are approximately 30,000 employees of Matabeni Group, and Matabeni has been continuously selected as a global Fortune 500 company. The world economy and the business environments around Matabeni are changing so rapidly in a way that is hard to predict. Under these circumstances, we have worked hard to strengthen our human resources to respond to any changes surrounding our company, as well as further improved our risk management capabilities. In doing so, we have made the full preparations for aggressively seeking out new business opportunities, even while continuing to manage the various kinds of risks we face. Currently, we are implementing a mid-term management plan, so-called SG-12, that focuses our management resources on four priority fields: natural resources, infrastructure, environments, and essential living commodities. By focusing on these fields, we hope to contribute to the further development of the global economy and the economies of individual countries as well. In addition, we will seek to contribute to the improvement of living standards in emerging countries, as well as to provide ultimate solutions to the environmental issues that are becoming more and more critical, given the world's increasing economic development. The continued trust of all of our stakeholders is absolutely essential to our sustainable growth as a general trading company. And Matabeni Group will continue to endeavor to be a partner that goes beyond your expectations. I look forward to the next opportunity to speak with you, and I hope I have such opportunity very soon. Thank you.
Beyond your expectations. Matabeni.
So sway Shang Ren Jidao. Jiu Shi Yao Fa Hui Li Ren Li Ji. 共存共荣的精神， 让人类的生活更加美好幸福。 丸红商店专务古川铁志郎。 前人的心愿得以代代传承，今天依然扎根在顽红人的心中，并且在全世界提升人民生活品质，帮助企业、国家走向富裕。曾经有个人这样想，要帮助一个国家走向富裕，同时也要拯救另一个国家的环境。心怀此愿的这个人，使两个国家的人民获得了幸福，给100万人的生活带来光明。立下此志的男士，点亮了100万人心中的明灯。要成为建设这个国家未来的力量。也曾有人这样想，他要培养更多建设国家的栋梁之才。要把珍贵的资源留给后代。而这个人找到了人类与自然之间的理想关系。要让世界焕然一新，这一想法仅仅源于一个人的小小心愿。为此，我们带着这一心愿，将世间所有联系在一起，将人与物、国与国、文化与文化、心与心、现在与未来联系在一起，今后我们还将联系什么呢？如何找到这个问题的答案，正是我们的使命。给子孙后代留下一个富饶的地球。 Generation to generation， 顽红。让我们将这个星球上的一切联系在一起。我们是综合商社顽红。随着世界人口的增长和新兴国家的高速发展，谷物市场面临严峻挑战。顽红凭借多年来构建起来的物流网络，在全球市场取得了飞跃发展。
谷物贸易的关键是如何增加产地、消费市场的数量。表面上看，我们是在从事谷物贸易，但胜负的关键取决于如何将谷物从 A 点运往 B 点的物流系统。
谷物贸易的全球战略基地在美国，那里的控制中心汇集并时刻更新着来自全球各地的谷物贸易信息。交易商们分析着时刻变化的产地、流通和消费市场信息，进行优化整合，及时准确地满足客户需求。在连接产地和消费市场的巨大网络中，最关键的是大型谷物出口集散中心， 其中北美出口基地波特兰港的五号港区是美国西海岸最大规模的谷物出口集散中心，由百余节车厢组成的大型货车源源不断地将来自内陆粮食主产地的谷物运进并排而列的巨大谷仓中，随后谷物被装进停泊在港口的大型远洋船舶中，出口到世界各地。2004年，丸红和美国谷物巨头 ADM 公司签署了含生产、进口和销售在内的战略合作协议。
ADM 通过将农作物加工成食品或能源制品，把产地和消费者连接起来。丸红不仅在日本，而且在世界各地构建了销售网络。两家公司将各自拥有的物流网络和沟销经验以最佳形式进行整合，进一步降低成本，为客户提供物美价廉的商品。自建立合作关系以来，双方又共同成立了运营公司，通过各种方式深化彼此在各领域的合作。
谷物由出口基地走向全球消费市场。北海道石胜港，2010年，丸红在石胜港建设了大型粮食仓储基地，由此完善了饲料的供应网络。此举被认为改变了北海道的物流格局。在亚洲 ，GNP 高速增长的中国市场，不断扩大谷物进口量，逐步发展成为亚洲和东南亚市场的中心。
中国是我们最为重视的市场。目前，中国每年进口4500万吨大豆，仅大豆一项就超出了日本每年粮食进口总量3000万吨。为此，我们和中国储备粮管理总公司集团旗下企业签订了全面合作协议。
此外，丸红预见小麦需求将会持续增长，向上海的食品加工企业克里斯汀集团注资。
谷物贸易的另一个关键是交易量的多少，为此不仅在亚洲，我们也要考虑扩大东欧、北非、中东等市场的销路。今后我们计划扩大规模，成长为能够和谷物巨头齐头并进的企业，增加全球谷物供应基地的数量。
丸红用强有力的经营网络联系世界。2008年，丸红从智利安托法加斯塔矿业公司收购了埃斯佩兰萨铜矿和厄尔特索罗铜矿两大项目各30%的股权，两者都是全球最大的铜矿项目，也是以铜矿巨头为首，得到业界各家公司普遍垂青的优质项目。
在埃斯普兰萨铜矿和阿尔特索罗铜矿两大项目中，丸红的总投资额达19亿美元，按照当时的汇率计算约2000亿日元，这一数字相当于丸红净资产的1/4。做资源项目时，有时必须远瞻未来，敢于做出重大的决策。当然，投资就伴随着风险，但是我们认为